The Catacombs, Notre Dame, and Luxembourg Gardens. Meet Jonathan Stribling Us. She's traveled to India four times, plays the violin, and enjoys singing. Meet Anaar Stevens. He lived in the Dominican Republic for 5 years and likes to play football. Meet Edward Mercado.
And here's Acme's senior agent in charge of training new recruits, Greg Lee.
Have a check. Oh, thank you very much. What a crowd. How you doing, Edward? Hey, Anaar. Hi, Jonathan. Nice to see you guys. Hey, they follow me to work every day.
Rockabella.
Yeah. And you know, the one of you that catches Carmen Sandiego today is going to get that trip to anywhere in North America, and that is not bad, folks. What a crowd we got today. So let's get started right now with our very first thing. Chief, who we after?
This is Serenade.
Serenade.
Carmen's criminal crooner with a voice so bad, it's a weapon. Her last known whereabouts, New Zealand. Rotorua, New Zealand, sits right on top of an active volcanic zone. Now, that means underground volcanoes sputter up steam through cracks in the Earth's surface, sending geysers into the air and creating pools of mineral water and boiling mud. Tourists enjoy relaxing soaks in the waters, while locals use the natural steam to heat their homes and swimming pools and even steam their food. At least they did until today. But now, Rotorua residents are really steamed. Serenade trucked into town, then rolled on down to the springs. She wanted cool new effects for her concert tour, and a steaming spring seemed just the thing. Sarah grabbed the geysers for her rocking road show, then hightailed it onto the highway. Gumshoes, don't let Sarah prove today's case. Nice geysers finish last.
Oh, yeah. That Serenade's a tough one, and also we got to get back to Hot Springs. So what we're going to do is start you guys off with 50 Acme Crime Bucks. Anytime you answer a question correctly, we'll give you 10 more Crime Bucks, and the two of you with the highest score at the end of this round will then proceed to the next round. So let's get started now with our very first clue, which... Oh, why, it's a flag. Don, why don't you tell the folks at home just what flag it is we're flying today?
Gumshoes, today's flag is brought to you by a country between India and China. It's the only country whose flag isn't a square or a rectangle. The flag started as two pennants flown on top of each other. It features this marvelous moon representing the royal family and this stunning sun symbolizing the Rora family, longtime rulers of the country until 1951. The flag as a whole signifies a prayer that the country may flourish as long as there is a sun and a moon. Available only in red. Back to you, Greg.
Thanks a lot, Don. Gumshoes, name the country. Is it Afghanistan, Nepal, or Turkey? Remember the clues that we heard between China and India, country whose flag isn't square or rectangle. Come up with an answer as quick as you can, guys. Trying to find Sarah and Hot Springs. And if you would please refer to me as Vanna for the rest of the show, I would feel very much at home. Everybody's ready. Edward, what do you say?
Well, Greg, I said Nepal.
Nepal, Anaar.
I said Nepal.
Nepal, Jonathan.
I said Nepal.
Everybody said Nepal. Everybody is right, ladies and gentlemen. That's the way to start that thing off. So that means Edward goes up to 60, so does Anaar, and so does Jonathan as well. Now, guys, for our next clue, we turn to a very average superhero with an above-average costume.
Look out, pal. Acme Man. Acme Man, if he can do it, maybe anyone can.
Not so fast, friend. That breakfast cereal you're about to eat isn't what it appears to be. Allow me, Acme Man, to change it while I give a clue to my friends at Acme. Thank you. Serenade's in a Michigan city west of Detroit. In the late 1800s, this town was a center for new ideas about health and nutrition that led to the start of the cereal business. Dr. John Harvey Kellogg was a local breakfast cereal pioneer, and his name still appears on the boxes today. There you are, my friend. You'll never know how close you came to eating a cereal with only 5 of its 10 essential vitamins and minerals.
Are you not impressed? Of course you are. Am I not the greatest superhero of all time? Of course I am. For I am Acme Man, and I am going away.
Acme Man!
Safety and security. That's what Acme Man means to me. Okay, Gumshoes, name the city, if you will, please. Is it Port Huron, Cleveland, or Battle Creek? Remember the clues that we heard. Michigan City, west of Detroit, Health and Nutrition Center in the late 1800s, and Dr. John Harvey Kellogg. Come up with an answer as quick as you can, guys. In our quest to try to find Sarah and the hot springs. Everybody's ready? No, not quite. Anar's ready. Jonathan is also ready. And Edward is ready. Edward, what do you say, buddy?
I said Battle Creek.
Battle Creek. Anar?
I said Battle Creek.
Battle Creek. Jonathan?
I said Port Huron.
Port Huron. The answer we're looking for is Battle Creek. Nice job, Edward and Anar. Very nice job, guys. Okay, now for our next clue, we turn to the freshest granny we could find. Please welcome Nana Rapp.
All the gumshoes in the house say yeah.
Yeah.
The country where Sarah's been showing her face, you might not know it's a musical place. It's a land that's home to the Maori and a local rap group, Upper Hutt Posse. If it's rock music that makes you thrill, there's Crowded House, Verlaine's, and The Chills. Now maybe reggae music's what makes your day, so listen what Bobby Lon's got to say. When in Australia, just hang a southeast where the joint is jumping, to say the least, with the Nana. Sing it to me softly, Nana.
I love her, Nana Rapp, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks, Nana. Okay, Gumshoes, name the country, if you would, please. Is it Papua New Guinea, New Zealand, or Solomon Islands? Remember the clues that we heard. Southeast of Australia, home to Maori, and Crowded House, Upper Hutt Posse. Come up with an answer as quick as you can. Edward is ready. Jonathan and Anar are still thinking about it. Now Anar is ready. I'm just letting you know what's happening over here. And now Jonathan's ready. Here we go. Edward, what do you say?
I said New Zealand.
New Zealand, Anar.
I said New Zealand.
Same thing. Jonathan?
I said Solomon Islands.
Solomon Islands. The answer we're looking for is New Zealand. Nice job, Edward and Anar. So that means Edward goes up to 80, Anar 80. Jonathan's still in this thing with 60 Acme Crime Bucks. Now it's time for one of my most favorite parts of the show, the lightning round. Hit it! Okay, all of these are about Sarah Nade's most recent known whereabouts, which is New Zealand. All of them are worth 5 Acme Crime Bucks. So hands on your buzzers, listen carefully. Here we go. The kiwi is New Zealand's national bird and the world's only bird that has these. Am I talking about nostrils in its bill, scales instead of feathers, or missiles under its wings?
Nostrils in its bill.
That's correct. Thank you so much for saying that. Yes. Takes up to 65. What were they thinking when they wrote that? Question two. The capital of New Zealand was named for the British nobleman who defeated Napoleon at the Battle of Waterloo. Was he Beef Wellington, the Duke of Wellington, or Duke Ellington? Edward.
Duke Ellington.
I'm sorry?
Duke Ellington.
Sorry, that's not the answer we're looking for. Anar or Jonathan? Anar.
Duke of Wellington.
The Duke of Wellington is right. Nice job. Yes. Surprised that no one chose Beef Wellington. Question three. The people of New Zealand have enjoyed a long tradition of equal rights. In 1893, was New Zealand the first country to free its slaves, give women the right to vote, or let kids pick what they watched on TV? Jonathan.
Give women the right to vote.
Is right. Nice job. 5 for you. That means at the end of that round, Edward has 80, Anar 85, Jonathan 70 Acme Crime Bucks. Now, for our next clue, we put together a little something with rubber and twine that I think you're going to enjoy.
Greg, come into my office now!
Yeah, Chief, I'll be right there. You guys want to hang here? This could be serious. Stay right there. Chief, where are you?
Greg, turn that mic off! Turn it, come over here! What's going on? I just came back into the office, and I think there's somebody in here.
Chief, there is somebody in here. You and me.
Oh. Greg, do the contest.
If you want to win, write down what got stolen and from where every time you watch the show. When you've collected 4 links and locations, put them on a postcard with your name and address and send it to Acme Crime Net, P.O. Box 4300, New York, New York, 10163.
Each day, we'll pick 5 people whose lists are correct and send each of them a Carmen t-shirt. Now, here are today's winners.
Congratulations to the winner.
Shh. You've got to take some serious action here.
Right. Let's get out of here.
I'm right behind you.
This is it.
Sean. What are you doing here?
I think it's quite clear, Chief. Sean here was trying to scare us out of the office so that he could have the inheritance all to himself.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
What inheritance?
Well,
put some clothes on. No, not here.
Great. Yeah. What?
What's this I hear about inheritance?
Barry, it's a joke.
A joke?
It's a joke.
A joke?
Yes.
Never mind.
Go to the phone tap, please.
Yo, Carm, these hot springs are way cool. I'm so into soaking.
Well, dry off and head for the eastern tip of the Arabian Peninsula. Sailors from this small rocky country have navigated the seas for centuries. Some say Sinbad the sailor came from here.
Sinbad? Whoa! I want to meet that dude!
I'll bet. During the mid-1600s, this country became a big trading nation, shipping lots of frankincense and ivory.
Oh, yeah! I saw the Bride of Frankincense! What a rockin' flick!
Okay, Gumshoes, name the country, if you will, please. Is it Jordan, Saudi Arabia, or Oman? Remember the clues that we heard. Small, rocky country, eastern tip of Arabian Peninsula, and sailors have navigated the seas for centuries. Trying to find Sarah and Hot Springs. Anaar is ready. So is Jonathan. Edward is really looking at that map, and now he's going to show us his answer. What'd you say? No, it's cool.
I said Jordan.
Oh, I knew that already. You said Jordan. Anaar, what do you think?
I said Oman.
Oman. What do you think, Jonathan?
Oman.
The answer we're looking for is Oman. Nice job, Anaar and Jonathan. Nice job, guys. Okay, for our next clue, wait a minute, that doesn't make any sense. I mean, there aren't any trains within miles of here. I don't know why I would hear a train whistle. Hi, guys. Hey, what's with the outfits?
Greg, we enrolled in train school.
Oh. We'll be working on the railroad.
All the livelong day.
I see.
And today we learned how trains help settle the West. Especially the line Sarah's on.
That's right, Mr. Leeser. That's right. Cyrus K. Holliday started the railroad in 1859 in the current capital of Kansas, and then the railroad expanded westward onto New Mexico, the capital of New Mexico, and then on to California, Mr. Leeser.
That was fabulous.
Yeah, well, you know, the cattle trade became big business because it was easy to transport livestock on trains, and new towns sprung up all along the route the train traveled.
Well, very good. Listen, thanks for the clue, guy. And have fun in train school.
Thanks, Greg. Hey, you know, tomorrow they teach us how to hammer railroad ties with our foreheads.
Well, never too late to, start a new career, which we all may want to be thinking about after a clue like that. Okay, guys, name the railroad, if you would, please. Is it Atchison, Topeka, and Santa Fe, Canadian National, or Union Pacific? Remember the clues that we heard? Railroad runs to New Mexico and California, begun in 1859 by Cyrus Holliday, and was important in settling the West. This one may be a little tough. Go ahead, try to find an answer as quickly as you can, guys. We're all sort of just thinking about it right now, but now the answers are coming very quickly. Edward is ready, so is Jonathan, so is Anaar. Edward, what do you say?
I say Ashland, Topeka, and Santa Fe.
Okay, Anaar, what do you think?
Union Pacific.
Union Pacific. Jonathan?
I said Union Pacific.
Union Pacific. The answer we're looking for is Atchison, Topeka, and Santa Fe. Nice job, Edward. So that means Edward goes up to 90, Anaar still at 95, Jonathan hangs there at 80 crime bucks. Now, guys, we heard that Sarah Nade has left the railroad, so let's pick up the chase. Take a look at these.
The chase.
Look at those costumes. Very nice. Okay, guys, all these worth 5 Acme crime bucks. Hands on your buzzer. Listen carefully. Watch the monitor. Here we go. Sarah sloshed with the springs to the Grand Canyon State. Name it. Jonathan.
Utah.
Sorry, it's Arizona. Next, she rafted the river that runs north-south through all of New Mexico. Name the river, Jonathan.
Rio Grande.
Right. Sarah scurried due north to Wyoming. What state did she cross? Anaar.
Colorado.
Right. She hustled the hot springs into Glacier National Park. What state is she in now,
Montana.
Edward? Montana's right. Sarah was seen sprinting to Idaho's capital. Name it. Jonathan.
Boise.
Boise is right. Nice job. That means at the end of the chase round, Edward has 95, Anaar 100, Jonathan 90. Give him a big round of applause, guys. Okay, take a little breather here, guys. It's time now for the final clue of this round, which means you have to decide how much you want to risk. Take a look right over here, if you will, please. Take a look at this map and think about it.
How much you gonna make?
Okay, looks like everybody's ready for our last and final clue.
It's a video music clue, Greg.
Oh, well, what is this?
I want these.
Looks like a video music clue. I'll just pop this thing in. There you go. Turn it on. Oh, hey, wait a minute. I know these guys. Yeah, it's Buckwheat Zydeco. I got a bunch of their CDs. See, the band's leader was nicknamed Buckwheat after the character in The Little Rascals. And Zydeco is the kind of music the band plays. It's good. See, Zydeco is dance music from the southwestern part of a Gulf state with a long French heritage. The accordion keeps the rhythm rocking, see? And you can hear how blues, rhythm and blues, and soul have all inspired Zydeco musicians. I could play this thing all day, but I got a case to do, so I'll turn it off. Okay, guys, name the place, if you will, please. Is it Louisiana, Georgia, or Florida? Remember the clues that we heard. Gulf state, French heritage, and Zydeco music. Come up with an answer as quickly as you can. Once you have it laid down right there in front of you, we'll get right to you. Jonathan, we're going to start with you. You have 90 Acme Crime Bucks. How much did you risk?
I risked 40.
40 Crime Bucks. What'd you say, Jonathan?
I said Louisiana.
Louisiana is right. All right, takes you up to 130 crime bucks. Edward, you have 95 crime bucks. How much did you risk, buddy?
I risked 20 crime bucks.
20 crime bucks. What'd you say?
I said Louisiana.
Nice job, Edward. Takes you up to 115. Anaar, you have 100 Acme crime bucks. How much did you risk?
I risked 30 crime bucks.
30 crime bucks. You look very confident. What'd you say?
I said Louisiana.
Hello. That means Jonathan and Anaar, you guys are going on to the next round. Give them a big round of applause, guys. Good job. Edward, buddy. Close game, man. Very nice job. Good detective work. We have some nice stuff for you. Chief, what do you have?
Crime fighting can be one tough game, but you must never give up. You must always be ready for your next case. And to be prepared, I recommend our new Acme Travel Pack. Look inside for the latest in anti-bad guy tools like an atlas, the official Carmen t-shirt, a subscription to National Geographic World magazine, and our Acme voice identification badge and leave a message wallet, perfect for storing messages and the occasional large pack.
Okay, guys, it is now time for us to
Greg,
go to... Yes, Chief.
Has this screen gotten smaller, or have I put on a little weight?
I don't need to answer that. You guys ready to go? Let's go to Louisiana. If you'll take my hat, you got the snack. If you'll get the door, I got the chief. Don't say anything about the weight. Okay, here we go. Go to Louisiana. Wow, Chief, so this is the car of the future, huh?
No, Greg. This is my old Studebaker.
Okay, gumshoes, here we are in Louisiana. That was very good. She got there. That's where you got to be. The chief is right here. We're ready to go. Chief, what do you say?
Gumshoes, there are 15 places here in Lafayette where you might find Serenade, the Warrant, or the Hot Springs. Let's look at a few of them. Begin your search at Acadian Village, where visitors get a look at 19th century life in this region. The village is actually a restored bayou town that was moved to this location. Now, you can't have a bayou town without bayous, and there are plenty near Lafayette. Bayous are marshy creeks or swampy backwaters common near the Mississippi River. You'll have to muck around every one of them. Then cruise with Acme's swamp surveillance team near Houma. They claim to have seen Louisiana's mythical swamp monster, Wookiee. What? The Wookiee monster? No. Sounds like someone watched too much Sesame Street. Finally, be sure to debrief these inconspicuous costume net agents for clues. Now, they're tough to spot because they keep a low profile, but hey, that's why they're the best at what they do. Now, you've got to be your best gumshoes. Head out into Lafayette and return the hot springs to New Zealand.
We'll do it, Chief. Thanks a lot. You guys know how this works. Loot, warrant, and crook is the order. You guys had the same score at the end of the last round. We flipped a coin. Anaar, you won that. So you will go first. Go ahead.
Louisiana Superdome.
Louisiana Superdome.
Sprung Springs.
Nice job. You got the loot. You get a free turn. Go ahead.
Tabasco Pepper Sauce Factory.
Tabasco Pepper Sauce Factory.
Serenade.
Very interesting. You got the loot and serenade. Remember, though, you have to go in the right order. Loot, warrant, and crook. Be careful, Anaar.
Audubon Park and Zoo.
Audubon Park and Zoo. Nothing there. We turn all three back around. Jonathan, go ahead.
Louisiana Superdome.
Louisiana Superdome.
Gruesome Springsteen.
Oh, very nice.
Wheelbarrow Parade.
Yes, at the end of the Tulane and LSU football game, the loser gets pushed in a wheelbarrow, or has to push in a wheelbarrow. Let's see it. Wheelbarrow Parade.
No.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Turn it back around. Whose turn is it? I forget. All this all right. Messing around. Anaar, go ahead.
Louisiana Superdome.
Louisiana Superdome.
Pressure's building.
Go ahead, Anaar.
Red River.
Red River.
The warrant.
You have the loot. You have the warrant. Can you remember where the crook is?
Tabasco Pepper and Sauce Factory.
Is Sarah still at the Tabasco Pepper Sauce Factory?
Sarah! You won!
That's your job. You know what to do. There's the chain. Go pull on it and put him in jail. Stay right there. We'll talk about what you have to do next in just a little bit. First off, listen, bud. Great job. Great detective work. We've got some great stuff for you. Chief.
Tough break. But Acme rules never bend. Only one gumshoe can capture Carmen Sandiego. Fortunately, Rule 43D states that every gumshoe gets this terrific Acme travel pack. And I've just signed an authorization for you to receive this World Band radio and guidebook to frequencies around the world. Now you can listen to news, sports, music, just about anything you want to hear from anywhere in the world. For your work on this case, I salute you.
Thank you, Chief. Here is your laminated portfolio inside this piece of paper and also a writing utensil. You know what to do. Write down where you'd like to go if you catch Carmen Sandiego and get the trip. You just take that snootful here. You knew what to do. She didn't know what a pin was.
Where do you want to go?
We're having a little discussion. You're not doing anything, are you? Maybe you can make a sandwich or something. You haven't thought about this beforehand, right? You keep writing. Keep writing. I'll get the phone. That's okay. Hello? She's a little busy right now. Well, can you take a call?
Yeah.
Okay, she'll see you now. Okay, hold on. I'll take that, and then you take the phone. Excellent.
Ah, oh, man, this prison is heinous. The guards keep playing music by Kenny G. Oh, get Carmen in here before I freak out. She's scooted to Africa.
Okay, looks like you and I are after Carmen Sandiego. Chief, what can you tell us?
Here's a list of places Carmen may have traveled. The Gambia, Cote d'Ivoire, Mali, Central African Republic, Egypt, Sudan, Eritrea, Ethiopia, Uganda, Kenya, Angola, Botswana, Zimbabwe. Greg, let's go to the map.
I feel good.
All right, and now you know what to do, right? Get one of these in your hand right there, buddy. Put 45 seconds up on the clock. Good luck to you. 8 and 45 seconds, you get the trip. Here we go. On your mark. Get set. Go. Carmen with the Bangui. Central African Republic. Central African Republic. Central African Republic. Do it. Hurry. Try it again. Try it again. Try it again. Hurry, 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 hurry. Come on, let's go. Come on. I just talked about Ethiopia. Ethiopia. Got to pour it on, buddy. Got to bring it up. Yes. Rwanda, Angola. 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 Go, buddy. Go. Get it up. Mine, Cote d'Ivoire, Cote d'Ivoire, Cote d'Ivoire, Cote d'Ivoire. Hurry, hurry, you gotta hurry now. Try it again. Do something fast, do something fast. Come on, come on. Gaborone, Botswana, Botswana. Do it, buddy. Pour it on. Come on, let's go. Let's go, let's go. Try it again. Botswana, Botswana. Oh, yeah, let's go. Kampala, Uganda, 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 Uganda. Oh, 445 seconds. Come on here. Give her a big round of applause, you guys. What's that? It's a tough map, man. Tough map, but you did a great job. You did some great stuff today. Chief, what do we have for?
We know it's a tough job, but you did find the loot and you did catch the crook. So you deserve a reward. How's this? A new portable CD music system, complete with stereo speakers, a cassette deck, AM/FM radio, and this collection of music from around the world. You made it. You're a sleuth. Congratulations.
Right here, buddy. Nice job, sleuth. Nice job, bud. All right, listen, you've been doing some great stuff for us today. There's one more thing I want you to do. You know what it is?
Do it!
Sneaks around the world, from Berlin to Carolina. Thinking make her felt shook from Berlin down to Belize. She'll take you for a ride on the dome of the China. Tell me, where in the world is
Carmen Sandiego?
Feel their soul in South Korea. My dear, nothing comes quite awful. But the rest is free.
For where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? And remember, cut it out now. That's enough. Don't take other people's stuff.
Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego? Where in the world is Carmen Sandiego?
All geographic information was accurate as of the date this program was recorded.
Where